In high school, I was in a few clubs. There was the stage crew thing, as I briefly mentioned in Weird Teachers. There's the marching band. Boy, that was an adventure of its own. There's art club. And then there's the club that this video is about. Robotics club. I would like to make something very clear about this experience. The organization that's in charge of this type of robotics club was great. I have no gripes with them. It's an organization called FIRST. They run and manage a bunch of different competitive leagues in all different ages and skill levels. They've got stuff for kids with FIRST LEGO League, and they've got this thing called the Tech Challenge, and then the thing that I was in was called the FIRST Robotics Competition. My gripes with the club have nothing to do with this organization that runs the competition. All of them have to do with my particular leaders and members, which aren't affiliated with the company as a whole. So like, please don't hate them. So, in my freshman year, the same teacher who was in charge of the stage crew suggested I join our school's robotics club. He thought I would enjoy it, as I really liked to tinker with stuff and work with my hands. I followed his suggestion and joined it, thinking I'd learn lots of cool programs and skills. Building a robot sounded fun. The point of the program was to learn how to build a robot and use those skills in competition. When I joined, I was told I would be taught how to build and program a robot for a specific task. Can you guess what didn't happen? When the club is starting up for the year, all of the new members were supposed to be taught how everything worked, or at the very minimum, part of something. How to build a robot, how to program it, stuff like that. So each week, when I show up, one person at a time got their training, then another. I at one point started asking when I'd be trained, and the answer was always, oh, the next meeting. The next meeting goes by, and no training. And so I waited. And waited. While I was waiting, I was given tasks that were still helpful to the team, but aren't really tasks that contribute to the competition. Other than one, making the bumpers. The bumpers are more of a regulatory thing. We have to make them so robots don't damage each other. It's part of the rules. But the task of making the bumpers wasn't really a technical one, and it didn't need a ton of innovation or outside of the box thinking. However, it's the only task that requires knowledge of sewing. I think the leaders of the club assumed that I knew how to sew for some reason. In fact, the only people they assigned to that project were the only two girls in the club. One of the moms who was with the group was trying to help us with the bumper project, and she goes like, oh, I need you to sew these two pieces of fabric together. I don't know how to sew. Okay. She was not thrilled. Time passes and I'm getting frustrated. I'm feeling like I'm getting nowhere with this group when all I wanted was to be a contributing member. Every idea I have for a design was shot down on the spot. I couldn't code and I couldn't build anything. I'd be sent to do tasks where I'd help someone load supplies in or food. I'd sweep. At times I was sent home early. My patience was wearing thin and I couldn't do it any longer. So one fateful day, I walk up to the student leader and have a talk with him. Hey, I want to be a contributing member of this club, but I have concerns. I was never taught how to work on the robot or program for it. I get we're busy, but taking the time out to teach me these things is really important and it would help the team. Oh, but you did a good job on those bumpers. Good work. I get those needed to get done, but it's really not the whole point of the group. That's like a regulatory side project. I need to learn how to work on the robot. Oh, we don't let girls touch the robot. This was the moment I realized the truth. They weren't too busy to teach me. They were avoiding it. They were actively undermining my value as a member of the team because I was a girl. I was fairly naive until this moment. Never before had I experienced something like this. I was in shock. How could someone treat someone else this way? How was this allowed? Why was he in charge? In my head, I was yelling at him and cursing, but I knew that wouldn't get me anywhere. Just like staying in the stupid club wouldn't get me anywhere. All right then. I quit. And at that, I left. Not to smack talk, but they weren't even very good in competition. I'm not saying my inclusion would have single-handedly made us win, but they got what they deserved by losing. So I guess I'm still a little salty even after all this time. And all of you watching, don't be like that. Nothing good comes out of not including others. I realized this video was a little bit more on the serious side than the last couple, but you know what? Sometimes you need those. You just need to to be for realsies and just, yeah. Anyways, how are you guys doing? I haven't seen you guys since Christmas. I'm trying to upload more. My apologies for the delay in videos. I had a lot of stuff happening in my life, some of which you can find out about on Twitter if you really want to know. Spoiler alert, it's not fun stuff. This end card is a disaster. Okay, yeah. Follow me on Twitter, check out my Discord, check out Patreon as well if you want to give me the sweet, sweet cash money so I can move out of where I am now. You don't have to. And yeah, see ya.